स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू योर चैनल। प्लीज लाइक, शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब योर ओन चैनल स्कूल स्टडीज। नाउ यू माइट बी थिंकिंग व्हाई टू सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल स्कूल स्टडीज। सो यू विल गेट डेली वन वीडियो रिलेटेड टू डिफरेंट सब्जेक्ट्स सच एज इंग्लिश ग्रामर, जनरल नॉलेज, सोशल साइंस, मैथमेटिक्स एंड साइंस, विच विल हेल्प यू टू अंडरस्टैंड एंड लर्न मोर। टुडे वी विल सी अ वीडियो रिलेटेड टू मैथमेटिक्स सब्जेक्ट। In that, today's topic is NCERT solution for class 7 mathematics, chapter 3, data handling, exercise 3.3. So let's solve that exercise of the textbook. In that, first question is, use the bar graph to answer the following questions. This is a bar graph given in the textbook. We have to use this to answer few questions. The first question is, which is the most popular pet? So while using this bar graph, we can see the most popular pet among all the pets are cat. So from the bar graph, the most popular pet is cat. It is owned by the 10 students out of 12 students. Second question is, how many students have dog as a pet? So we can see there are 8 students have dog as a pet out of 12 students. Second question, read the bar graph which shows the number of books sold by a bookstore during 5 consecutive years and answer the following questions. So this is the bar graph given, number of books and the year. Scale is 1 unit equals to 100 books. Now, about how many books were sold in 1989, 1990 and 1992. So we can see in the bar graph, in 1989 there are 175 books sold. In 1990 there are 475 books sold. And in 1992, 225 books were sold. Second question, by observing the bar graph, we can see there are 475 books in 1990 and 225 books in 1992. So in the year 1989 and 1992, the number of books sold were less than 250. Now, by observing the bar graph, we can conclude that the number of books sold in the year 1989 is about 1 3/4 part of 1 centimeter. Scale is taken as 1 centimeter equals to 100 books. So 100 plus 3/4 into 100. That is 100 plus 3 into 25. 100 plus 75, that is 175. Next question is, number of children in 6 different classes are given below. Represents the data on a bar graph. So that are class 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th and 10th. Number of children in 5th, it is 135, 6th, 120, 7th, 95, 8th, 100, 9th, 90, 10th, 80. The first question is, how will you choose a scale? So we will take the scale as 1 unit equals to 10 children. Because we can represent a better and clear difference among the number of students of class 7th and class 9th. Second, class 5th has the maximum number of children, that is 135, and class 7th has minimum number of children, that is 95. The total number of students in class 6th is 120 and the total number of students in class 8th is 100. Their ratio between the number of students of class 6th and 8th is 120 upon 100, that is 6 upon 5. Means 6 is to Fourth, the performance of a student in first term and second term is given. Draw a double bar graph choosing appropriate scale and answer the question. So this is the question given. English, Hindi, Math, Science, Social Science. The term 1 marks and the term 2 out of 100 marks are given here. The first question is, in which subject has the child improved his performance the most? Second, in which subject is the improvement the least? Third, has the performance gone down in any subject? So let's see the answer. In the first question, we can say, by observing the double bar graph, there are maximum marks increase in the math subject. So the child has improved in his performance in math. While observing the double bar graph, the improvement was least in social science. And the performance in Hindi has gone down. Fifth one, consider this data collected from a survey of a colony. Favorite sport, watching and participating. We have to draw a double bar graph choosing an appropriate scale. What do you infer from the bar graph? Which sport is most popular? Which is more preferred, watching or participating in sports? So this is the double bar graph. Number of peoples and sports. The figure above in the double bar graph, which represents the people who prefer either watching or participating in different sports. By observing the double bar graph, we came to conclude that most of the people like watching and participating cricket, while least number of people like watching and participating in athletics. By observing the double bar graph, we come to conclude that the people who like watching and participating cricket is the tallest among all the bars. So cricket is the most popular sport. Next, by observing the double bar graph, we came to conclude that watching sports has more preference rather than participating in sports. Next question, take the data given in the minimum and maximum temperature of various cities given in the beginning of this chapter, that is table 3.1. Plot a double bar graph using the data and answer the question. The questions are, which city has the largest difference in the minimum and maximum temperature on the given date? Which is the hottest city and which is the coldest city? Name two cities where maximum temperature of one was less than the minimum temperature of the other. Name the city which has the least difference between its minimum and maximum temperature. So this is the double bar graph. The temperature is here and the city's name is here. Green shows the maximum temperature and pink shows the minimum temperature. By observing the double bar graph, we came to conclude that Jammu has the largest difference in the minimum and maximum temperature on 26/2006. Jammu is the hottest city and Bangalore is the coldest city. By observing the double bar graph, Bangalore and Jaipur, Bangalore and Ahmedabad. For Bangalore, the maximum temperature was 28 degrees Celsius, while the minimum temperature of both Ahmedabad and Jaipur was 29 degrees Celsius. Mumbai has the least difference between its minimum and maximum temperature. So this was exercise 3.3 of chapter 3 of class 7. I hope you liked my video. Thanks for watching my video. Thank you. Please leave comments, question or doubts in comment section if you have any. Or you can drop a mail to us. You will find my email ID at the end of this video. You can also join us on Facebook page, follow us on Instagram, connect us on LinkedIn or tweet us on Twitter. Thanks for watching my video. Thank you.